our pair of series here have diverged in, like, some ways, huh? Our time with Isaac began taking actual baby steps through brown hallways and hyperventilating and the slightest exertion and cutting up meat, and then that became taking slightly larger steps and double-tapping meat in the chest with a rifle. Just like a normal one. You could cut them up if you wanted, and, you know, we did for tradition and entertainment's sake, but he still didn't bring his inhaler to work, and, well, I mean, you were there for the rest of it. It very quickly devolved into box hallway stalker, with occasional meat steps. On the other hand, we started as Wayne, back on our first trip to EDN3, and then lost our Wayne job because the Wayne went bad. Some things happened, some snow happened, some bugs happened, and we had to temp around for a little bit. Met a whole host of colorful, briefly present characters. Our helmets were super dumb, our plans were dumber, and our squad poses were tight as fuck, though completely inappropriate. We're gonna step into, like, one of the last legs of this trip. The series, well, I'll leave you to look at them as we get to each one. But I will say that one looks forward and one looks back, but chronological focus aside, the boundaries leak in some very interesting ways, I think. Did you figure out what it is that they've lost yet? Not their funding, that's too easy. We know how I feel about easy. Not their futurist franchises, either. That would also be entirely too easy. We'll see if you can guess it. Maybe you already have, maybe you haven't. Before we jump in, I do want to talk briefly about a Lost Planet spinoff that we won't get to play, because it was only released in Japan, and frankly, in seeing some of the art, which I'll put up for you in just a second here, that's probably for the best, because I guarantee if I had gotten my fingers into this, I would have been extremely unkind to what is undoubtedly someone's absolute favorite chirpy anime bullshit. I'm not a fan of the saccharine Lost things. I can appreciate goofiness, I can appreciate lightheartedness, but there's something about the presentation we get in most anime that just I find grating and puerile, and it's not my bag. It might be yours. Feel free to carry that if you please. Anyway, the game in question here would be EX Troopers, released in 2012, released for the 3DS and PlayStation 3 exclusively in Japan. Stars students of basically Nevik High School, stationed on EDN3. We have our hot-blooded lead. That's Bren. We have his very special VS, which is, of course, an advanced prototype, because you would trust advanced prototypes to rando shithead high school students. That's just how it works. We have Christ, I'm actually reading the wiki right now. A Julie Fleischer, a student at Nevik Tech Base on EDN3. Described as a bright mood maker who excels in the handling technique of her personal customized PTX vital suit. That's the hardballer. We have T-Key, a priestess of the next generation of snow pirates, which aims to coexist with the indigenous biological Acrid, which is not really something we've seen in the series so far, is it? Snow pirates and Acrid seem to have a predator-prey relationship where you shoot the bugs to get the orange sauce, to rub that into your face, and this pleases Wayne, who is your god. Apparently this character that I'm speaking of is also waiting for something called The Awakening, which is vague and ominous. The wiki also mentions that she can communicate with Akrit, which, okay. Sure. Because again, we haven't seen much in the way of, you know, any kind of, like, intelligence on their behalf, or structure. They're space bugs. They come out of space bugtopia. That's it. That's all we got. Some concept art, why don't we? There we are. In just a moment while I grab this and kind of wrangle it free from the internet. Formats, transparencies, all that fun shit. Here we go. Here's Bren. I don't know about you, but I feel like Wayne would be displeased. I know our temp would be displeased. Who is this kid? Why would you follow him? Why would you trust him with any kind of piece of advanced machinery? And let's see that advanced machinery. There we are. As I wrangle free the transparencies in that one too. Boom. Boom. Come to me. There we are. That doesn't look anything like the vital suits that we have, does it? I don't know who was in charge of this particular project. I could probably find out. What do we got here? Looks like... Oh, we just have a producer. But the character art was done by Chisato Mita. I don't know if that includes the mechanical stuff. Sometimes the vehicle designer and the character designer are two different people. Anyway, they seem to want desperately to work on a project that isn't Lost Planet, and I would encourage them to do so. Because the direction for this is just all over the place. Let's get rid of that. Alright. So, of course, we will not be talking to Bren. We will not be getting to know his VS, which does have a voice and does call him Master. Isn't that charming? We will not be speaking with his anime rival. We won't be talking to the mentioned snow pirate that wants to coexist aside the Akrit. But I warn you, this will be a theme that they visit. Like the other games. Oof. Hopefully that's not terribly loud. It may have corrupted its audio source again. We're going to swap that back and forth. There we are. There we go. Anyway, like several other games that we've played, this one does not support borderless window. It makes me do this. This is the menu. It already looks kinda sorta samey, doesn't it? With its blue holograms and its blocky shapes. It's sort of like the Dead Space menu, just with higher resolution. Thanks, Iron Man. Now everything looks like this, and I fucking hate it. What is this over here? What is this? All of these little widgets and crap? They are nothing. That's because that's what that UI was designed as. You look at it, but it's nothing. We're going to do normal. It's a new campaign. Grandpa.
Please.
Kerrigan?
Please say something.
Oh, never mind.
Diana.
What is it?
You're on my hand.
Just stay calm, I'll dig you out. Your
harmonizer's toast, but I gave you mine. There's not much tea energy to draw in.
Did it work? Are they safe?
I think so. Kaven gave them cover. If they stick to the plan, they should be miles deep before Nevik punches through.
Good, good. You need to be gone when they do.
Fat chance, old man. You're my only family, and I'm not leaving you in here. Damn it, why can't I move this thing?
You're as stubborn as your grandmother. No, you were right. I deserved every word.
No, just forget about that, please. It doesn't matter.
It does. When you've been keeping secrets so long, it's hard to stop. There are things you have a right to know.
We'll have time later.
Stop.
Come on. Damn it.
Damn. You know, back on Earth, my father believed you had to confess your sins if you want to be forgiven. He never got the chance, but maybe this is mine.
The Earth was a troubled place when I left it. I was 32 when they recruited me. A bold and lucrative opportunity to be part of an expedition to an unexplored world. 50 years ago now. 50 years of living with the consequences of my choices. 50 years since I damned us all.
Well, that was an unhappy landing.
God damn, it's cold. How long do you reckon before they come for us?
Depends on how off course we were blown by the storm. However, it appears the transponder guiding our welcoming party to this location was lost in the crash. Without that, our odds of survival are remote. I suggest we find it.
Stay here while I track it down.
Well, here we are. We're a suspiciously familiar looking man. I don't know if we necessarily could get the rights to the face we wanted. But this is before Wayne, before Joe. I will say that I like the look of their hostile environment suits. These are quite nice. And we hear acrids. You know what, just a moment here. I'm going to turn this down in my headphones. For whatever reason, this game is extremely loud. Okay. Well, the witch is telling me that it's kind of loud on her end as well. We're going to do our best to fix that. Yeah, she's asking me about her audio ducking. Let's go ahead and nudge this down just a bit. Try to get a good balance between me, the game, all kinds of stuff. We'll also just kind of do this. So these sound effects are quite loud. And on the listen back, if things need to be adjusted further, I'll adjust them. But for now, we're looking to not blow out my eardrums.
I don't think we're alone out here.
Alright. Doc, we're not alone out here. Back at it. It's more agreeable.
I hope that wasn't a transponder. Let's get some light in here.
So already a much different kind of look and feel to the technology in the world than the other Wayne planet entries, huh? Some connectivity issues, maybe? Is it back? Any further problems? Okay. Oh, that sensitivity is gonna have to be changed, too. That is too wiggly. Fuck you, yes I did. Anyway, she's accusing me of not doing shit with my pre-production. My response instinctively, fuck you, yes I did. But it's an odd one to fiddle with. Capcom's games are, particularly of this era, are strange. Down we go. The sound mixing in general. All over the place. Anyway, we remember these guys. Maybe not so kissy-faced as they are right now. Our UI is a lot more minimal, isn't it? We don't have quite so many things telling us what they do and do not have in store for us. We've just got a rough read on how much ammo we have, so, you know, an aiming reticle. No health or anything yet. No map. No secondaries.
You look.
Well, that would be because you don't look further for the thing you just found, wouldn't it, Peyton? His name is Jim Peyton, by the way. Now, we could take some shots at them. There's also not much of a reason to. The game was telling me to make sure to look down my sights. And now we see some acre that we have not seen before. These guys are new. No, I have to mash F. Somewhere between this and Wayne, those simply died out.
Bonjour, mes amis. The cavalry has arrived.
And the cavalry is French.
Thanks for the save. I owe you one.
Oui, oui. Le roi, c'est moi. Time enough for that later. Head back to the supply drop and try not to get stepped on, huh?
And we see here the predecessor to the VSs, the utility rig. These great big square clanking machines.
Kovach, Dr. Kendrick Kovach. Don't call me Kenny.
Hey, my name's Hutchings. Friendly Frenchman's LaRoche. So, you're not packing a long-range firearm, are you?
Not on me. But somewhere in that ship, I got a 30-06 old family heirloom. No idea where it's packed. Got my pistol, though.
Good enough. Give me a second.
I'm going to retire to the relative safety of the interior. Good luck up here.
Okay, bye, Kenny. I live by no man's rules. Specimens.
Please, kill them.
All right, relax, Kenny.
Non-aggressive indigenous
Oh, buddy, you're gonna learn to take things Nevik tells you with a grain of salt. In fact, some days you might need a bucket of the stuff.
You sound like Diaz.
Hey, say what you will. She raised some valid questions.
Yeah, sure, sure. You mean she blathered insane conspiracy theories every time you're trying to drink in peace? Why even work for a company if you accuse it of such things?
Who's this Diaz? Sounds like a character.
She's the one you're replacing. A contractor like you and I. Until she disappeared.
Man, this supply drop couldn't have come sooner.
We, the ready stale, and also the pornography.
This Braddock's gun. Oh, son of a bitch!
Ah, son of a bitch.
What's happening up there? Have you been killed?
No, I made it in one piece somehow. What now?
Your environment suit is within umbilical range of my rig. You should be seeing extra tactical readouts. Minimap, radar, loadout details, as long as you stay close to the rig. Tu me comprends?
Good deal.
Use your radar to see advancing enemies. Look now!
And there we go. Now we see some of the advantages of staying close to the rig.
The animals leave behind. You will need it for later. As fast.
That's what gives us our heads-up display. Some extra information on it. You know. How much thermal energy we've picked up. An actual ammo count. A mini-map. Wander too far, those things go away.
Damn it, the snowcat's been damaged. Hey, you're in construction, right? See if you can repair this thing.
Yeah, I see the problem. Give me a second.
Okay. Just a moment here. Just kind of looking at things on my end.
Newbie.
Still looks alright.
First, you have to find the proper repair frequency.
Yeah, thanks, boss. I know what I'm doing here.
Do it yourself. Huh.
And this is repair. We're finding the frequency. We're pressing and holding V.
Okay, you're
it's repaired.
Heads up. You got incoming.
So we are in construction. Apparently. And Jim evidently knows how to fix machines.
back on the dropship.
On my way.
There we are. Jim, don't wave that around your head like that, man.
Great. Now, hold on. LaRoche, you take the high road while I round the bend.
Aye, 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 sir.
And that was my introduction to EDN-3. Baptism by fire. The rest of the trip to base camp was uneventful, but my calm didn't last for long.
Look, you weren't her only friend on this base. We all miss Diaz. But I tried to warn you, Nevik would never use that as an excuse until they started seeing results.
It's not about Jeanette, you know it's not.
Oh, so you're still blaming me, though?
I never said that.
You didn't have to, you just checked out.
They're looking for something that doesn't exist. I'm directing my efforts where the science leads. That used to matter to you.
It still does, Bonnie, but this isn't my call. Nevik is footing the bill for this operation. They insisted.
And that's it. Not a peep from you.
Not a... It's only because of me that you still even have a job here.
Oh, yes, a job answering to... Him.
Dr. Kovach. Glad to see you made it in one piece.
Yes, it's been an eventful morning. Phil Braddock, I presume? Mm-hmm. Dr. Roman? It's been some time.
Feels like yesterday, Kenny. You'll excuse me.
Okay.
And you must be Jim Peyton. You really stepped up out there. You must have a million questions. I hope you don't mind being thrown into the deep end.
Sir, I'm here to work. All I need to know is how a man can earn some credits around here.
Thermal energy. That's the name of the game.
Acrid blood? I hate to tell you, boss, we just spilled gallons of the stuff.
Oh, it's well more than that. Flows through everything on EDN-3. Creatures, tectonics, all the way down to the core. Makes life possible in a climate like this. No other substance like it in the universe.
And Nevik believes this can solve the energy crisis on Earth.
Oh, I believe it can. We're here to study it. Find a way to make it viable, cost-effective for harvest and export. We are leaving no angle unexplored.
Very good. Science is always best, without boundaries.
Peyton and I got a lot of contracts that'll keep you busy. Construction, repairs on the base, but, if you want to go home a rich man, you'll take on that hazard pay. Keep us supplied with this stuff.
Yes, sir. Just point me to my rig.
Peyton, I can't recommend strongly enough that you visit the quartermaster and get yourself a good hunting knife. You've seen how up close and personal the acrid can get. But first you want to head down to the service pit and inquire with our lead tech, Gale, as to the status of your rig. Welcome aboard, Jim. Doctor, if you'll stay and chat. Sorry you had to see that. You know Bonnie can have a flair for the dramatic.
Is that what that was?
Yeah, Bonnie's got a flair for the dramatic. Our technician's name is Gale. I don't believe it's the same one. Oh, backspace access job log. Boy, doesn't that look familiar, too. You see what I'm saying? People don't believe me when I say that these things overlap a little bit too much for comfort. Anyway, we can see a number of things here. We got our missions. We got a map. We have our available weapons. Player upgrades. Rig upgrades. Those others will come online as we do stuff. Also, the cutscenes being grainy, and kind of low resolution, nothing I can do about that. They just look that way. In-game... tends to look a whole lot better. Well, I mean, don't mind if I do. A text log? You know I must. Page up and page down to scroll. No, I'll be using my mouse. Jeez. Okay. So, my darling Jessica, my love for you warms my heart and keeps me from freezing during these harsh sub-zero nights. I see you everywhere. The stars in the sky are your eyes. The windswept fields of snow are your perfect skin. So why haven't you written back? Tony says he hasn't seen you at the house lately, and credits I've been transferring into our account disappear instantly? Please reply. H. Dumont, having some problems.
Attention! The water pipes in East Block will be frozen over for at least the next 2 hours. Turn all faucets on and keep them running until the problem is solved.
There we go. The barracks. We have our thermal energy heaters running. We have an audio log this time. Well, I mean, we simply must. There we go.
Didn't seem like too much of a Nevik toady, but the way he buckles to these crazy rules, man. Here we are in a turf war with these acrid, day to day, hour to hour. But if we put weapons on a rig, oh no, then we're not a science op, but a military op, and Braddock doesn't get to be in charge. Like, anyone's gonna rat him out for letting us protect ourselves.
And so we see some inner conflict in Nevik. We can't put weapons on our utility rigs because then it becomes part of the military department of Nevik. Looks like a defrosting tank. Crazy Neil. You know I'm going to talk to a man named Crazy Neil.
Cold enough for you? It's never cold enough for Crazy Neil. Ice in me veins. Back home, I used to spend summers at McMurdo Base in Antarctica. Long family tradition. My great-great-great-great-grandfather took part in Operation Deep Freeze, and my great-great-great-great-grandmother was a penguin. Now that's a joke, son. You understand?
I do understand jokes.
There ain't nothing funny about sexing a penguin. Not even if they're begging for it. Yeah, cute little bastards, but temperamental. Kind of bitchy, matter of fact, but say what you will about them, they hardly ever try to eat your head. You know not to eat the snow, right?
Well, Neil, that didn't make any fucking sense. Back into the tub with you. That's much deeper than I anticipated. Deep enough to maybe drown Neil. We'll think about it. Another text log. You know how I love these. Alright. Arbrugate. Or Brugati. Possibly. When I get back to Earth, here's a small sample of the many things I never want to see again when I get back to Earth. Snow, ice, frost, crampons. Crampons? Crazy Neil, crabs. In that order. Thanks for sending this across stars, across space, across time. To whoever the fuck. Here's a list of things I don't want. That guy's snoozing. Looks like we're trying to expand the base. And I really like the design of their hazardous environment suits here. They share a kind of utilitarian and workmanlike quality that, like, you see in some of the Dead Space rigs as well. They look purpose-built, and not impractically so. Anyway, nothing left to do in there. We're just going to have to continue on. Through the base, we're taking our tour. We can sprint if we wanted to.
Well, a new person.
Yeah, hey. Okay. That's all he's got to say. Alright. Barracks, the laboratories. This is Gale's service pit, the armory. T-energy tanks. We do have to go there. There's nothing to do in the bays at this particular point in time. We'll see them soon enough.
I know everyone's excited about the supply drop, but no crowding this time. I see anyone near the inventory out of turn. I'm docking his next paycheck for time lost.
Okay. This lady's got the right of it. She's got full face protection, but she walked directly the fuck away from me. She's not interested in talking right now. Neither is this guy. We'll have to talk to him in just a moment. Ma'am, I'm not following you. I just have to go over here and talk to Gale. Oh, you have to talk to him too, do you? Alright, that's fine.
Anybody home?
Oh, hi.
You must be the new Jeanette.
I guess. Call me Jim.
Jim, outstanding. Welcome to EDN3, Jim. The E stands for extreme. Still working on the rest.
That's great, kid. You want to point me in the direction of your boss?
Oh, Mr. Braddock? I think you'd have seen him already, but, yeah.
No, I mean the lead tech for this bay. I think they said her name was Gail.
Oh, right. Yeah. That's kind of me. I know. I hear it all the time. Girl's name. Shouldn't I be off looking for a date for junior prom? Dude, I understand you're concerned. But don't worry about a thing. I am totally getting college credit for this gig. I'm kidding. Not in the mood. I read you.
Listen, kid.
Gail.
How about we do the get to know yous while we work on putting my rig together?
Whoa, hey. Are you serious?
Yeah. It was shipped ahead in pieces. Now that I'm here, we can build it.
The thing is, I kind of put it together last week.
Come again?
It's a nice solid rig you got. Pretty intuitive design. It was no trouble. I had fun with it, really. All the diagnostics checked out. In fact, I just got done with the finishing touches.
What finishing touches?
Threw on some spring-loaded Kerna retractors. Jeanette said they always came in handy when the heat was on, which happens more often than you'd think on an ice planet. Get it? Ice planet, because the heat...
Kid, listen to me and listen close. I got three things in the world. My wife, my son, and this rig. Guess which one I'm counting on to take care of the other two. You follow? That is my whole nest egg. I built it myself. I know every gear, every circuit, and I can't have her breaking down on me because some intern needed to show off.
Can I just say two quick things?
Please.
Okay, first, you can't really say in the world anymore because you're on another planet. Sorry, just pet peeve. And secondly, okay, it's your show, Jim. I'm just here to help out. Give it a test drive whenever you feel like it, and if it ain't ship shape, break it all down by morning. Deal? I promise you won't be sorry.
Let go of my hand.
Okay.
Well, Jim's kind of a piece of shit. Yeah, okay.
Take your time.
Yeah, thanks, Gail. Anyway. Yep. We gotta go to the principal's office. Anyway, Jim's kind of a piece of shit. The lead tech here went ahead and assembled his work vehicle. Like is his job, you know? Get out there, get to work as soon as possible. I can understand the owner-operator mentality of going like, well, I'm hoping that that's done right. But someone being younger than you does not mean that they aren't capable, Jim. We really do have to keep that in mind. Also, there's a lot of surprisingly old-fashioned values from this spaceman here. This suspiciously familiar spaceman. Hi.
I heard the whole hangar jawing about how we were getting a fresh pair of faces around here. I'm the quartermaster, name's Bowers, but most people call me Birdie. You make an honest dollar, you come spend it here, eh? All right, pal, take your time eyeballing the wares. I'll stay out of your hair.
Thanks, Birdie. Anyway, Birdie here also looks like he's from the Imperium of Man.
Top of the line for up-close protection. Comes with a lifetime guarantee and unlimited free sharpening. Not that you'll need it.
Unlimited free sharpening, not that we'll need it. We can see that our weapons are a little bit different. They have things that, you know, we can stick to them. So our weapons can be upgraded, and we buy our extra ammo packs. We'll scroll down. And a specialized component that can be used in Gale's workshop for rig upgrades. We're gonna grab the shotgun for right now, because we'll probably want that.
Now that's a sweet one. Pump action, 9-shot capacity, synthetic stock and forearm. She's ideal for your close quarters combat.
Birdie sounds so much like a number of gun shop guys that I've spoken to in my life that it's kind of fucking eerie.
Thanks, Jim. You keep fighting a good fight.
Thanks, Birdie.
Yeah. Nice meeting you, Birdie.
Okay, yeah, you know what? You chime in too, huh? You gonna be a chatty one? You gonna be a chatty Kathy? Anyway, I like the looks of the weapons that we see in this as opposed to what we see in Lost Planet. This looks like a shotgun you would actually use, fire. Pump action is weird. And that magazine tube is also kind of small. But, you know, whatever. I believe here is sometimes a shooting range that we might be able to fuck with. Well, okie doke. We've replenished our ammunition. We'll get to try this out shortly. We've got a knife that they made me pay for. Nevik made me pay for the knife. We have a shotgun they made me pay for. It does have a reflex sight on it, though. That's nice. That's good of them. Alright. To the main bay. Yeah, a dead silent loading screens. The witch is just remarking on how quiet they were. The loading screens have no music, no nothing, just the void. Take a moment, drink it in. Hey, Gail.
Jim's heading out, so let's prep the rig, people!
I got here not very long ago. I don't think I've slept or showered. Haven't eaten, definitely. It's time to work, though. Nevik is cracking the whip. Here's our utility rig, and again, I very much appreciate these. Yes.
Not bad at all.
Thanks. Didn't need this, though.
Oh, that Gale.
Oh, you ready to try this? Dry treated. Hypertensile kern retractors. I like to call it the Cockpit Express. You got one on the front, one on the back. You just clip in, give the line a tug, shoop!
And by shoop, you mean launch myself up at solid metal from 10 meters down and hope I don't break my neck?
As an alternative to being eaten? Yeah.
Sure it is.
He didn't clip to anything. He just yanked it, huh? And this is our job as Jim. We have an actual job. It is not Snow Pirate.
Okay, the rig's passed our diagnostics check, but let's see if those servo controllers are working like you remember them. Go ahead, test out that claw arm.
Mouse one is claw arm.
Now test the drill arm swing servo with a punch.
We can swing the drill arm.
Notice how much faster your arm's swinging? Just a little gift from yours truly. Okay, just a few more tests. Now the drill.
We must hold mouse two to drill.
Great. Lastly, I upgraded the shielding on your rig's bracers to class 4. Try a defensive posture. Beautiful! You'll be using that move here on EDN3 more than you have probably on any other job. Sweet, we're done. Let's release your rig. Be free!
Thanks, Gale.
LaRoche, come in. Corona's base to LaRoche, do you copy? God damn it, we can't lose LaRoche now. We barely have Diaz replaced.
Hey, Chief. Jim Payton here. You copy?
Payton, is your rig online already?
Yeah, looks like the kid here might know his stuff, but I'll know for sure after I take her out for a spin. That French fella still not back?
Yes, I'm afraid he hasn't been responding to radio calls.
Well, why don't I go have a look for him? I know where we parted ways, and he did save our butts just a little.
Say no more, Payton. You got your first assignment. Good luck.
Okay, we have to go find LaRoche. We got a picture of our wife up in the corner. Remember that. That'll be important later. There we are. Our cockpit is locked. There is a way. Just a second here. I want to see this. Because I believe Jim has brought his hot jams with him. And we're gonna wanna hear. There we go. F2. Jim's hot jams button. We're gonna want to hear Jim's hot jams. So yeah, this is our job as Jim. We are a space truck miner.
Would you look at that?
The utility rig, does a lot. This is Coronis Station, and part of our operation here.
Hey.
There's our wife.
So I'm just gonna decide that it's not weird to be having a one-way conversation with you. Not weird at all. Yeah. Hey, I thought you might need some music up there to keep you sane, keep you thinking of home, so there's a playlist for me attached to this message. Hopefully it all magically works and you can play it as soon as your rig's up and running. Okay, that's it for now. Just let me know you got there in one piece, okay? Miss you already.
How bland, thank you. Anyway, she sent Jim his Hot Jams tape. I don't know why it is that it wouldn't work, as you know, we're in the future here. It's probably just like an MP3. The witch insists that it's probably an MP4. We got that guy doing stuff. You should probably put out some flares if, like, I'm gonna be driving this space truck through this corridor. We can also see that it's a lot different to work this than it was to work the VSs. We're gonna be doing a lot of bug boxing while we have use of the rig, while it can fit in places. Because it is also much, much larger than the VS's, isn't it? I assume it also runs on a different power source because we don't have a ticking thermal energy thing going on.
Best to follow the trail.
There we are.
This is Peyton. You still read me?
Peyton, Corona's actual. Copy you loud and clear. Any sign of LaRoche?
Well, I found his rig back at, let's see, White Canyon Junction. Looks pretty beat up, but no trace of the man himself.
Thanks for the update. Just keep looking. I know he's out there somewhere. Braddock out.
Like here. There's really nowhere for this thing to go. It doesn't jump. So, down we go. Jim never hooks in. Never. He also never wears face protection. It's startling. Anyway, our pistol has unlimited ammunition.
Hello? LaRoche! 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 You out here? You out here? You out here?
Yeah, that's how echoes work. From what? Oh. I guess they just kind of died. Well, down we go. LaRoche has barricaded himself over there. But, you know, we have to... You know how this goes. I don't have to explain this to you, Lost Things. There's thermal energy on the ground. There's bits of orange. We need that. Hey.
C'est de conneries. I had that crab out of its shell and ready to dip in butter. Then 1 foot slits over the ledge and my whole rig is on her back. Did you see what he did to her?
Nothing that can't be fixed. You're lucky you got out with all your limbs.
Ah, keep your perspective to yourself, rookie. Fight a few giant crab monsters of your own, then speak to me of luck.
Fair enough. Guess we're even.
First, we survive. Then we keep score.
Well, we know these guys. Jim doesn't, but we do. And we know what their vulnerability is. Jim can also do that, which is not something Wayne knew how to do. Around we go then.
This is Peyton. I found your Frenchman. He's at a fueling depot near Watkins Pass.
Oh, that's a relief. Sending out a rescue team now. Good work, Peyton. You should find your account credited with a search and rescue bonus. Hold on. Peyton, you say you're near Watkins Pass? Your predecessor, Diaz, set up a thermal post nearby. It's been sitting full, wasting T energy since she disappeared. Locate the post and tap it before you return. Just be careful. Acrid like to nest around untended thermal posts. Good luck.
Well, there we go. We have nav markers. I'm unclear on something. Let me go ahead and check the controls one more time. And probably a few more times. We have dodge, we have sprint, we have aim, we have fire, grenade, grappling hook. We remember that. Zoom, repair, special action, quick turn, use, operate, struggle. Struggle, stab. T-post. Nope. Does not appear that we have the option of destroying that corpse. Not even to get the precious goods inside. Anyway, our nav things don't remain on our screen. We have to press N in order to bring them back up. That would be part of where LaRoche was hanging out. Pi, I just think that it's a fine addition. Like, you can cling to your quest markers if you want. That's okay. But I don't always need something to be telling me. I'd rather be able to summon it. You know, just to be able to say, where am I going? Oh, that way. Got it. A whole lot of the three-legged, three-jawed ones there. This is Jim sprinting, by the way. This is as fast as he goes. Are we missing frames again? Okay. Well, let me go ahead and do this real quick. Double check on things. Do I have notifications? It looks like it's just our connection. Yeah, no notifications. Okay. And back to it. One day we'll be free of Comcast Lost Things. One day. But that will take time. There we are. We're locating the thermal energy post. Thank you. even with the sensitivity where it is, this still is floaty and strange. I'm wondering if it has some kind of like weird issue with acceleration, because it's originally like, you know, for your thumbsticks. Amy sets this off. Okie doke. That's better-ish. We'll see if I maintain that opinion or if it gets cranked lower. Oh, that one's a magician. Scooted behind that and disappeared. We remember how this works. Now they eat them. They eat the grenades, like those things will swallow them. So we don't have to shoot them anymore. I'm wondering if we still can, though. We'll save that experimentation for just a little while from now. He's trying to get the creep up. Wow. Let me see that again, Jim. Yeah. You see, Jim also seems to have gone to gun school. Jim is holding his gun correctly. This is what your grip should kind of sort of look like. You see how the thumbs are stacked on top of each other? We're pulling it back into our grip. Oh, we got bits. Well, of course, why wouldn't I? P is an awkward thing to press. You take your hand off the mouse and press P. And there we are. We have these little crawling segments. Jim will do that on his own, where we can't fire our gun. Those explode, and they put jelly on our face. Yeah, it'll be fine. Don't be a baby. There we are. And these are, you know, acrid eggs. They used to give us orange stuff. Now they just explode and spray things on us. Could be a result of acrids just continuing to adapt and evolve. Could be any number of things. Who knows? My bet is that it's just the developers going, well, what if we had some more environmental hazards? All right. We're in. Okay, we're in the nest. Let me double check something here. We're double checking. We may be having some connection issues that I'm just sort of checking up on. Doesn't look like it so far. Possibly. Well, when we're done here, we'll do another watch back, and if it's unacceptable, I'll just do the same thing that I did before and fucking redo it. Small deal, you know? There we are. Okay. Well, let me know how that, how it looks over there. If we need to just take a moment, tweak things, and then start again, that's fine. Okay. Good deal. Sorry about that lost thing. So, you know, we're just continuing to hammer out stuff. Anyway, we're in a nest. We're looking for that thing there. They said we had to tap this mast. Which sounds like a euphemism for something else. Ah, we know these. We know what they're for. And we know what to do with them. Pardon me a second. I require the contents here. Those are mine. I've appropriated them.
I was sitting out a squall near Dawson's cutoff when I saw it. At first I thought it was a trick of the light, but there was no mistake. I called Coronis and they confirmed what I already knew. Nobody was out here with me. Braddock thinks I'm paranoid, but I know what I saw.
That should do it.
Diaz out.
Well, Diaz has apparently discovered the presence of other people. Nevik says that's not true. And we have activated our cell phone tower. We got thermal energy from it. My brain defaulted to having to mash a button. They changed it to hold. It's kind of like they sort of changed the steak jingle on me for Monster Hunter World, and it threw me for a loop for like days. You can't do that to someone who's been doing this for decades. It wasn't that big of a deal, of course. You just learn the new timing or correct the old timing where it was wrong. Okay. But it is a little bit jarring when you go, oh, well, I'm used to this pattern, and suddenly it's something else. Storms are brewing. Live navigation? I do. Our objective is to return to the rig. Jim, you ought to put an optic on your pistol, honestly. You got a thigh holster. We're not looking to conceal the thing. Maybe there will be one later. Some archaic grenade design, though. These big thick potato masher things. Pie, you making a break for the garbage? He's convinced there's treasures in there. He won't listen to reason. There we go, we can see those grenades a little bit better.
Mayday, mayday. Peyton, this is Coronis Actual, requesting immediate assistance. Are you there? Copy.
Coronis Actual, yeah, this is Peyton. I copy. What's going on?
Peyton, get back to base ASAP. Emperor-class storm bearing down on us from blind sector north-northwest. ETA 3 minutes. We need you to secure the base moorings with your rig. We haven't had time to reinforce them since that last damn storm. You copy, Jim? Hightail it here or there won't be a base to come back to.
Roger that, boss. Flying in. Peyton out.
Great freaking gig you got here, Jim.
Jim's complaining about his job, but frankly, it's right up my alley. Again, I wish the game that I'm being presented with here was true to its intents that it seemed to be putting forward. Like, this notion of living the life of a frontier energy prospector on a faraway planet. and just kind of making do against the indigenous life forms and that whole faster than light travel issue and faster than light information transmission. Which is weird to me that Capcom, of all developers, seems to pay more attention to the issues that poses than Dead Space does. Dead Space, who just has them call each other up and, you know, the reception's a little bit shitty, but whatever. Capcom says they probably have to record a message and then send that via courier, right? And yeah, you would. But yeah, doing things like securing moorings for your base in the middle of a great big storm in order to make sure that your base doesn't incur damage or lose functionality or something like that would be, I think, a wonderful thing for something more survival-focused. Oh, our rig has a weapons locker on it. And doing that with a tool like this one.
Where the hell are you? We need your rig to secure the base moorings before the storm gets here. Get back to base and leave it.
Now I'm going. It only goes so fast, Chief. Oh yeah, in a more kind of open, less narratively focused setting, I still think that this could be really something. And naturally, I prefer these utility rigs to the VSs. The VSs are nice to be able to swap things and all that stuff, but this one's enormous and ugly.
Zone 5 mooring is gone. Evacuate all Zone 5 pods. Repeat, evacuate Zone 5 pods immediately.
Alright.
Tension line secure and awaiting mooring stabilization.
There we go. And so we see, the utility rig is in fact.
Peyton, quickly, use your rig's claw arm to grab and tighten all three of the moorings.
We're rotating. Rotating W, rotating A. Doesn't seem to be responding to that. Let's see.
Peyton, hurry up and secure the moorings.
WSAD, no. Doesn't seem to want to do this. A moment here. I have a solution. It's going to mean plugging this in. Excuse me while I rifle around for a moment. But I did anticipate this being an issue.
Peyton, there's no time to waste. Get your rig to that mooring and tighten it.
There we are.
Now we're going down.
Yeah. I'm doing it.
Zone 3 stabilized, but we're losing pressure on elite centralizers. We need Zone 2 secured.
There we are. So it looks like we're just going to have to swap controllers. Because it did not want to recognize that. That's okay.
Damn it, Peyton, the hydraulic tubes have burst. You'll have to get out on foot and repair it.
All right. And here is our repair tool. It's the thing on our arm. We just poke it the same way we do to activate cell phone posts.
Secure that mooring.
Yeah, that really does not seem to respond to the keyboard at all. Bizarre. Ooh. Okay.
The storm's almost here. We're gonna have to close the blast doors.
Yeah, we'll do. How come there were so many of you for a second? have things hitting the windshield. I liked the storm effects here. I still like them now. I wasn't expecting to care for them as much, but this feels like a storm.
Corona stabilized. We're in the clear.
All right.
Blast doors ready. Waiting instructions. Corona's actual.
There we are. We're escaping into the hangar. I like the ice accretion on it, even.
Blast doors have been closed. Lockdown in effect. Damn, that was close.
Scratches and smudges.
That was clutch. Man, we didn't even get to hazing them yet. Outstanding work.
Alright, we really came through. We can't talk to the boss right now. We gotta get this thing powered down and scrubbed. Nice. Alright. Well, yeah, they include this music player. And...
Alright, man of the hour, you should yep. see an objective marker on your HUD. Just
yeah.
follow that and dock your rig in the bay.
Get out of the way, man. Anyway. They include this music player, and it seems to suggest that we'll be spending a lot of time doing stuff like this, right? Just somewhat dangerous, mildly adventurous errand work.
Gale, from the sound of all the cheering, I'm guessing the rig's working all right. Kermit tractor's coming handy out there?
Yeah, kid. You done good.
Not an I'm sorry, though, huh, Jim? We can still hear his music from outside. Jim's that kind of guy. He's the kind of guy to park his motorcycle and just blare the radio. Alright. We're on the main deck. We could go to the basement and kind of fuck around there for a moment or two, but let's go talk to Braddock and see what he wants. And hopefully this next stream that we do with this, now that we've kind of worked out the kinks with this game being loud and strange with controls, will be a little bit smoother. Not that I think anyone particularly gives a shit.
You're back. I haven't just been standing here the whole time, if that's what you're thinking.
Who are you trying to convince, pal? Me or you? Also, where do you get one of those masks? Because breathing in cold air like it's supposed to be out there is not great for your lungs. But, all right. Your lungs can freeze. Did you know that, Lost Things? They're perfectly capable of freezing and you damage the alveoli within. Is that the right term? Now it's going to bother me. A moment. I'm pretty sure that's the... Yeah, a tiny sacs of air in the lungs allow rapid gaseous exchange. Yeah, I got it. Okay. All right. Crisis averted. Hey, Braddock. What's up, man?
There he is. LaRoche and everyone here at Corona's owe you big time, Peyton.
You gonna pay me?
Sure know how to make an entrance.
Corona's actual. You copy? It's serious.
Talk to me, Jay.
Observation pod 5 disappeared into the ravine out of umbilical range. We're trying to get a visual from camera 8, but the lens is frozen over. I'm rounding up a rescue team, but they need to know where to set up the harnesses.
I'll let Peyton head down ahead of them and make contact. Keep me updated. Out. Peyton, that drink will have to wait. Here, this is a standard issue Camelot Felding grappling hook. You'll need it to descend the ravine. Don't waste a minute. I want them back alive.
Okay, Chief, but I probably gotta go shopping first. Anyway, now we have the grappling hook. You guys know how that goes. It's Lost Planet. The grappling hook is super handy. It lets you get around and stuff. Still does here.
Are you jogging laps? Is that it?
Yeah, that's what I'm doing. Basement. Your pistol has unlimited ammo at all times. Remember that. I agree, Pi. I don't think that was necessary for this kind of game. Limiting your ammo is fine. We just have to go ahead and model and consider what else it is that we're doing with the character. Can we expand ammo by just kind of putting extra mag carriers on the belt, or maybe a backpack can be affixed to allow for other kinds of things like that? It's something to think about. Extra pack that allows you to carry more ammo per weapon. A stock upgrade. And a damage upgrade for our pistol. Why the hell not?
Nice. She'll pack a bigger punch now, though the trade-off's a touch more recoil. It's well worth it, in my humble opinion.
Thanks, Birdie. Of note.
You're rummaging around for scrap, huh?
No.
Good deal, good deal. You be careful out there, kiddo.
Okay, thanks, Birdie. Yes? Yes? We're not gonna open it, huh? I'm gonna have to do this manually. That's fine.
The president and his opposition allies pulled out of a national unity government today due to fears that the militant Crimson Unity Party would claim remaining energy reserves. Crimson Unity was instrumental in the government's collapse when its well-equipped militiamen overran much of the country in September, forcing the president to cede to a severely crippled National Unity government. With the energy crisis firmly rooted and little hope of resolution, observers fear that this latest development will cause a domino effect across the region, plunging the entire continent into turmoil. For IBR, this is Suzanne Lee.
So we get some backstory as to what's going on Earth, and we notice that the Crimson Unity sounds an awful lot like the Crimson Snow Pirates, doesn't it? They may be related, I'm not sure. I'm also sure the wiki mentions it. I've been knocking these cones into the snow. They just clip right through. There's an energy crisis. Someone's government, we're not sure which country, they just say the country, has been knocked over by Crimson Unity.
Sweet! Let's do this thing!
Okay. So, we can see that we have some things that we can fuck with our rig. This is one of the first ones that we're going to want, and, you know, allows it to collect thermal energy. Extra health. And we have some stuff for moves. A forearm bash. And a three-hit combo.
Till next time, boss.
Anyway, what was I saying? Oh, on the pistol caliber exchange there. Some frames of handgun do allow you to put a larger barrel and therefore chamber into the gun. And a lot of times it's within certain tolerances, like, you know. We are probably not going to be able to convert a 22 LR pistol into anything. But for Jim's, I think it's safe to assume that what it is that he's done is either taken a frame sized for 45 and bumped it to 10mm, or a frame sized for 9mm and bumped it to something closer to like 40 Smith & Wesson or whatever, and then just loaded it real hot. We don't ever really get to say, because that's just not the world that Capcom lives in. But it's not out of the question as far as an upgrade, and I was happy to see that. It's not just you put more screws in it so it do gooder. We're a traveling man by the Novemberists. Lady, clear the way, come on. Are you shitting me? Are you shitting me? Ma'am. Christ. It's a high traffic work zone. There's heavy fucking equipment here. Get out of there. All right. We're out there again, this time planning things for search and rescue. See if we can help some of those people that went over the pods during the storm. Which, again, I like this setup for objectives. This is good.
Okay, slight problem. Looks like the blast doors got frozen over solid. You'll need to manually force open the hydraulic door pistons with your claw arm. The pistons are on either side of the wall there.
Oh, this it works with. The claw arm. She's... The witch is reveling in the accents that she's hearing. She hasn't heard them in quite some time. Yeah, I copy. Okay, listen. Listen to me, all right? I'm walking over there. Don't tell me how to do my job, pencil neck. I'm sorry, you know, it's reflex.
That should do it. Opening blast doors now. Be careful out there.
Yeah, I'll be careful out there. Okay. Looks like this is where we're going. And already, we have to get out of our space truck. I'm going to assume that everyone enjoys the same music as I do, because I'm Jim Peyton. Here we go. Press F to rappel.
Hello? Is there anybody out there?
Yeah, bud.
You got pretty lucky. Landed on a solid outcropping. Seems stable enough. Anybody hurt?
Our life support's offline, and we could really use some air.
Okay. All right. Fucking stop gasping.
Hey, it must have gotten crushed in the fall.
Slow breaths, man. Slow breaths.
Yeah, I see it. Purge tubes are all tangled up. Give me a sec. I'll see what I can do.
Already, we've done more fixing than engineer Isaac Clarke did.
Yeah. Oh, I can hear the life support kicking in now. Thanks, Jim. You're a lifesaver.
All right, you fellas sit tight. The rescue teams will be down here in a jiff.
And what about the... Okay.
I already like you better than LaRoche.
Well, that's a low bar to clear, friend. Oop. We got those explosive ones still. Anyway, the music is really trying very hard. About the same gameplay involvement, though, which is unfortunate. And I wish that if it were that the tubes were tangled, there could have been maybe a grab and pull sort of mechanic to get them untangled. And we have a moment here to take a look at what it is they've actually done with Jim's sidearm. Now, when you do a barrel swap, say, for example, you have a SIG gun, a lot of times you can do a caliber exchange on those. You would remove the barrel, replace it, the gun would look no different on the outside. It would just have a different caliber marking on the part of the chamber that you can see. What they've actually done is added something called a compensator. Or a muzzle brake. What it does is it vents gas. You can do this in conjunction with fucking with your actual barrel and what size bullet your gun is throwing. But a lot of times with pistol caliber, there we are, weapons, this isn't necessary. Extremely hot rounds that are going to hurt your hand, they don't come in semi-auto. And we have a twist on the explosive boys. They do that. And we have to play Gears of War for a second. I have already for... it's space. Okay. Well, that's sort of strange, but why not? Something to note for game developers, if they're going to do this compensator route, they make your gun very loud. Can I? No. It won't let me gather things with my grappling hook. That's a Dead Space 2 only thing, I guess. Dead Space. Lost Planet 2. Okay. Is he just gone? Was that a suicide dive? It's weird. Well, I mean, don't mind if I do. Someone just left their rifle out here. It's mine now. We found it. We want those logs.
Nevik survival tip number one. Know your storms. There are five classes of storms based on unique characteristics. In ascending order of severity, they are Chancellor, Cardinal, Bishop, Monarch, and Emperor. Details can be found on page 185 of your Nevik operations manual. Memorize and know the difference. Stay safe. Stay educated.
No. Anyway, some background there. There's storm codes. I see. They've decided to hang out around my my rig. Don't they know that Jim only has three things in this world? Honestly, again, it's a sweet sentiment and everything, but he says it in the most just. For, at least for me, the most uncomfortable way possible. There we go.
Excellent work, Peyton.
Dirty water dog.
Now it's time to get down to the nitty-gritty. We surveyed a new thermal pocket nearby at Hanneman's Basin, and we'll need you to plant a T-post to drain the pocket.
Okay.
This is probably your most important duty, keeping the base supplied with T-energy. Uploading the coordinates to you now.
So you would think that we would be doing a ton of this, right? That this would then become part of our routine. That's what it sounds like. Oh, here we go.
Hey, Gracie, got your message loud and clear. And the tunes. Great thought. Thanks. I'm here in one piece. Might be overstating it, but we made it. I'm safe. Just getting oriented. And yeah, there's nothing awkward about this at all. Guess we're gonna have to get used to it. Keep sending, okay? Remind me why I'm out here doing this. I miss you.
Okay, well, that's what Jim sent back to his wife. I'm not entirely sure how long the messages can be for them to, you know, take them along. There we go. Never miss a good chance to shut up. That's a good song title. Oh.
Hiya, Gracie. Gotcha.
Yeah. We've seen that before. It looks like I just kind of fucking flopped back through the boundary there. Anyway, that's the message that Jim sent his wife, and I'm not sure if he's constrained by, like, data limits, length limits, something similar. But you'd think there'd be maybe something a little bit more personal to that. And is it all that awkward? Jim, it's just a recording, you know, say hi. How's it going? I'm all right. Looking forward to seeing you soon. Maybe talk about some of the shit that's gone down, provided you're not under an NDA.
Jim, your remittance transfers have been set up as requested. 15% of your contract payments will be paid out to you in the form of T-Energy, since that has become the normal currency around the base. The rest of your earnings will be credited to the account on Earth you provided. Vadapalli out.
Thanks, Vadapalli. Our direct deposit is all set up. That's about it. What? Oh. I have to drill this. Fuck you. We've done it. This drill really probably should have been like a singular thing, shouldn't it? And it likely shouldn't be that shape. It should probably be more like a rock chewer. Well, they're leaving. For some reason, we'll find out.
Delta Station, looks like we've got another sudden Emperor-class storm heading in from Blind Sector North-Northeast. You've got 2 minutes to secure storm shutters and hightail it down to the hangar. Let's move!
Alright. And we see the storm rolling in. And what it's kind of doing to the environment. Assessment within safety margin. Sick. It's a pretty environment, isn't it? I like it. There we go. Yep, we've iced over. That's okay.
Oh, you gotta be kidding me.
So it seems that EDN-3's ice deposits come in violent waves. And again, that would have been quite interesting, I think, to experience in a manner that isn't just... hang on, I have to tap F. Okay, and there we go. That's what the knife is for. We poke them in the mouth. And eventually they get the picture that no means no. The fucking pose. Also, don't carry your knife vertically in that position, please. What we have to do here is de-ice our rig and kind of try not to get too fucked up by these guys in the meantime. However, they are also good for thermal energy. Still shoot these? No, it went off before I could. Mostly because I got tapped in the spine. And we can see that's our damage model. It's the standard, you know. You've been touched, so here's some gel on your face, and it'll recuperate itself eventually. Same. I gotta remember that the dodge is a thing. I see you. Give ourselves a moment to recover. Oh, we're pressing F again. There you go. That's one. We can kind of see on the acrid that as they take damage now, their interior gets dimmer and they kind of start to bleed. Sort of through their skin almost. Okay. Looked like a charge, didn't turn out to be. But they still freeze solid. You know, like you do. We can destroy their corpses with, well, at least some of their corpses, anyway. No dice there. It looks like it simply must be. With something that punches a little bit harder than our pistol. Anyway, I'm also quite certain that they will continue to respawn until we're out of here. You'd think the ice on the claw wouldn't be as much of an issue, but it is. Up we go. We're free and clear. And now that we're in the rig, this is really not a problem, is it? He doesn't want any now. We smeared our cockpit with orange stuff. I want that. And we can see that our loadout options here have changed. We have options for an assault rifle, we have shotgun shells, we have grenades. And every time we use that locker, we can restock our ammo supplies. Up we go. Looks like this way is the way that we're going. The storm is mostly past. We'll have to get out and go on up there from here. And we're out of range. I wish for the grappling hook they had really thought about, you know, some sort of harness for that. It seems as if, you know, with talk of clipping in earlier, that someone had a thought to, you know, how it is that you support a human body with a rope, but they abandoned it. Looks like that's the place. Also looks like we may have company. Something was moving around. Oh, and the music has now become very ominous. Can't go that way. Looks like we'll just have to grappling hook back up. Yeah. Just ammo. We'll remember that for later. I'm sure we'll need it then. There we go. It's a big one. Hey. Well, come on down here, make a thing out of it. They move very similarly to a lot of the quadrupedal kind of dog or cat-like creatures in Monster Hunter, don't they? There's still a lot of echoes of that, even in this iteration of Lost Planet. You wanna... Well, come on out here if you want an ass-whooping. There we go. Oh, you went and got friends, I see. I'm surprised that the shotgun doesn't blunt that charge. No, that time it sort of did, and I was stuck in a fall animation. The game could not decide what to do with me after that display. Hey Jim, how about to the side? There we go. It's supposed to be a directional input plus space, but it seems like it has some issues recognizing what direction I'm supposed to be moving in. That's a common issue that I've seen with a number of games that are built with analog sticks in mind, that they're not really super conscious of what it is that you're putting in. It mostly kind of guesses. Stinger. There we are. Oh, that's right. Pardon. I want your bits. I did appreciate at least that these guns save the pistol, which, you know, at a distance maybe, but they at least sound like guns. They're muffled, of course, for the listener, but there's a reverberation and stuff to the crack of the bullet. That kind of roar you hear afterward is a result of bullets traveling at supersonic speeds.
Fueled by finding these thermal pockets on your own, planting T-posts, and maintaining them when they're full. Harvest them regularly, and you'll be raking in the credits in no time.
Got it, boss? I think this work is just my speed.
I mean, it's certainly mine, Jim, but we don't... Well, I don't want to talk too far ahead.
And so it went for weeks and months until the extraordinary became commonplace. Dealing with the cold wildlife became the new routine. Intense is real, but routine. I kept my sanity and wits by not thinking too deeply about what I was seeing and doing. It got lonesome sometimes, out in the Badlands. The music and weekly messages from the missus kept me company. I was making great dough, getting choice contracts. That was the point, after all. I made friends with the crew. They're a right good sort, those guys. Even LaRoche, for all his bluster, had his moments. For better or worse, I became Braddock's go-to guy. It had its benefits, but sometimes being the one to get the call meant you ended up in some damn strange situations.
What's wrong?
Plenty.
Harmonizers aren't a set of juice. One time I won an acre to attack.
Where was I?
Something about getting the call.
Yeah, right. Well, now you know how hard it is to communicate off-world. In those days, Nevek had a workaround. An antenna relay on the
highest peak in the area, so we can call home to Mama with minimal storm interference. It's our lifeline. 2 hours ago, we went offline, and we don't know why. We're effectively cut off from sending and receiving any off-world communications. Some acrid probably got his claws into it.
So once again, you expect me to march out there and fight a horde of monsters in a rig without weapons, huh? Do you know how much of my income I waste on repairs? I want guns on my rig, a simple chain gun.
My hands are tied. Nevik regulations.
Yes, yes, don't weaponize the construction vehicles, but I mean in this case...
Nothing. I'm not going to jeopardize my operation because of your nerve deficit. It's called hazard pay for a reason.
Oh, please.
Hey, boss. Just noticed ComSat's offline.
Yeah.
Mind if I hustle down the relay station? Give her a gander?
I was just talking to Mr. LaRoche about that very thing. Apparently he's got some concerns about making nice with the wildlife.
Well, no, I don't want to just snake a man's contract.
No, no, no. Take it. Get yourself killed.
Not for at least double, I mean.
Done.
What?
Be back by supper time.
So like I said, Jim is a real piece of shit, huh? just a real fucker. Anyway, the game that they described and I don't get to play. There we go. Birdie's got new shit for us to buy, so we're gonna...
This is Dr.
Okay, yeah, hey.
Loud and clear, Doc. Kinda told you, you can call me Jim.
As you like, Mr. Jim. I was hoping you could pay me a visit in my lab, as your circumstances and logistics allow. Oh, and I believe I'm to mention that remuneration is involved.
So you have a job for me?
I believe I made that abundantly clear.
Oh, abundantly. I'll drop by soon, Doc.
And we see Jim also falls into that pitfall of... well, in English, Poindexter. Yeah, you know what remuneration means. You fuck. Also, why wasn't Dr. Kovach played by Jeffrey Combs? Outside of they couldn't afford Jeffrey Combs. Alright, that's where I am. Lab's up there. Let's go talk to him. So yeah, Jim is snatching other people's contracts and making real nasty deals with the boss in front of another employee's face, and he's of course shocked when that employee does not like him. Anyway, the game that they describe, yeah, dead. Okay, he's sprouting up like a beanstalk. Hank is Jim's kid. The game they describe that I don't get to play there, where we go and plant those posts and harvest them regularly and kind of build up our stuff, get to know the crew, make the bizarreness of this situation routine. That's something I desperately want to play.
He needed something to take his mind off the cold, so I gave my brother's guitar. For never having taken any lessons, he's damn good. Listen.
I mean, he's okay, but is his arm okay? It's a very large guitar. Yeah, if you're just noodling around, then this is what you got. That's not bad. You got an ear for music. This is the kitchen. This is what they were building before. I'd imagine it's because now we have more employees. Kind of lounge.
Know why they call him Old Man Braddock? It ain't on account of his age.
Okay, apparently he's stressed. That's the president withdraws. No, I'm sorry. Yeah, we know that one. Do you want to play it? Okay.
After months of rolling blackouts to fight record strains on the power grid, the president is attempting to tackle the national energy crisis head on. This morning, he unveiled a new energy...
The president's trying to do an energy crisis thing. President of where? I don't know. They're not going to tell me. The president. You know the one. You've seen him. We'll talk to Kovach. We'll see what Birdie's got. That the base is mostly tunneled into ice is also quite nice for my brain. If a structure is there and you don't have to do too much of your own manufacturing? Don't.
Stand by.
Save time, save money. Dr. Litke. Yeah, what's up?
Remember that 800-page questionnaire we all had to fill out before we came to this planet? How the hell did Kovac pass the personality screening? He must have cheated, right? I mean, have you spoken to the man? Every time I look at that enormous head of his, I imagine a little alien inside operating at controls. Or maybe a super intelligent lab rat.
Okay. All right, bye. Bye, Litke. That seemed very rude. Hey.
Ah, as you are undoubtedly aware, I've been tasked with rendering thermal energy a viable and cost-effective power source. Unfortunately, the T-energy from subterranean sources, while plentiful enough to run the Coronis installation, has a purity level entirely too weak for the audacious experiments we seek to conduct.
So, the stuff we drill out of the ground, not pure enough for science.
If paraphrasing me is critical to your comprehension, then yes. Now listen, the acrid. There are wild variances in their impurity index. Some are promisingly pure, potentially pure enough for our purposes. I need a survey of local acrid, samples of their tea energy, in the hopes that we can find one with a pure enough composition.
So you want me to kill acrid, basically?
Yes. I'm hoping to take advantage of your noteworthy efficiency as a killing machine. So, let us begin with the Sepaya, those wretched things that so bedeviled our arrival. If you could kill 20 or so and collect their T-energy samples, I should be able to extrapolate a purity index through vertical analysis of the...
Kill 20 acrid, bring you this bill. That's the gig? All over it. Thanks, Doc.
Let me update your map with the best place to look for them based on recent sightings and migration patterns. And if you'd kindly hold still, I'd like to equip a sniffer attachment to your suit's tank. It'll automatically gather samples of T-energy particulates in the air after you've made a kill, so you can just focus on the killing.
Okay.
Such pitiable incuriosity.
Kovac, I agree. We are creatures of a similar cloth. Peyton is gravely incurious. He doesn't want to know, doesn't want to hear about it. He's content to listen to his extremely similar tunes and send strange and uncomfortable messages to his wife. This is not a face hugger. It's important that you not call it that. It's not. That's not what it is. And so Kovac has, you know, basically a side hustle for us. Go and slap things. He's going to directly compare the samples and basically see what acrid bodies are doing with the thermal energy in hopes of getting a more efficient fuel out of it. Think of it as the difference between, you know, crude oil and gasoline. It's just the refiners are biological and have kissy lips this time. Well, don't mind if I do. Pi, it's not stealing. They left it there. It's not stealing, and if you narc on me, I swear to God, dude. You're not even legal in some states. Categorized as an invasive species. Yeah. Yeah. I know. All right. But yeah, so, like, with all of these structures and stuff being what they are, I wish this game had allowed me to linger in the way that some more modern titles do, and we'll get to one of them at some point in time. I'm sure people are familiar with Metro by now. It's not like it's some kind of super undiscovered gem, but I don't know that it gets the appreciation that it deserves. And I'm sure a pattern is emerging. I like these cold, dark, seemingly... For most people, inhospitable places, they're comfortable for a number of reasons, and I don't know, maybe that'll be the the theme that we start talking about. Things that I found in my travels that bring me a sense of comfort. Because, of course, I am aware that this has been, I don't want to say mean-spirited, but there's one series, and we're in it right now, that I enjoy on its own terms, and another series that seems to be desperately trying to seem cool to me that I keep making fun of. Hey, that's an exploded diagram of the assault rifle that we found in the woods. The big old fucking forend, like this heat shield for the barrel is unnecessary, but whatever. The witch is telling me I have 4 minutes left. We can extend the magazine. You know we have that. The hunting rifle will be available. We've also got these components and shit happening. We're getting to that part. The hunting rifle... Well, we'll also get to that.
You keep fighting a good fight.
Okay. I will, Birdie. I will. What do we got? I investigate the comm relay. We did that. We'll do that. Okay. So Diaz's old post has some stuff for us. At least they remember, you know. And we'll investigate the comm relay. We'll probably do all of that next time. We're a little bit out of sorts here, and I think we're just about done and ready. We can, while we're looking at things, just take a look at what they tell us about our weapons. Pump action shotgun with solid stopping power, but limited range stopping power is a myth. If you're purchasing a firearm, tells you about the stopping power of something, stop listening to them. There's no way to, like, actually quantify or qualify the term stopping power. Standard issue Nevik assault rifle, corporation with its own standard issue assault weapon. A versatile weapon well suited for a variety of tactical engagements. Frag grenades, basic shrapnel grenade that damages any target within the blast radius. Our player upgrades, we got our repair tool, we got our grappling hook. Apparently made by Camelot Felding, and it's apparently standard. Rapid vertical ascent and descent to and from stable grappling points. And the energy sniffer. No rig upgrades yet, but we'll work on that. Does this... In fact, only saves with the autosave, so we will probably scoot our way here and make an adjustment, if possible, to our rig. And that should automatically save it, right? Right. Oh, this is another log thing. Well, go on and play it. You're not gonna automatically play those anymore? You pain in my ass? You fucking traitor.
I was sitting out a squall near Dawson's cutoff when I saw it. At first I thought it was a trick of the light, but there was no mistake.
We've heard this one before.
I was sitting out a squall near Dawson's cutoff when I saw it. At first I thought it was a trick of the light, but there was no mistake.
That must be it.
I know it's early, but I was seized this morning by the divine spirit of artistic creation. I was at breakfast and Colbeck had come up with these griddle cakes made out of vital wheat gluten or something, and it got me thinking about the corn my folks used to grow when they still had their farm on Olympus 1. And I was saying how I couldn't have been more than 10, but I built this thing called a cornipole, but it's really more of a slingshot, and then I realized nobody was at the table anymore, so I came out here and I installed some kern retractors on the new guy's rig. It's like a human cornipole, see? Except, you know, kinda not. Hope you don't mind. I should get some coffee. Or sleep. Yeah, sleep's good. Yeah, coffee's better.
That's a character they decided needed to be in this game. I can follow his reasoning, though. If you were to use something like the Kern retractors that he's got here in the form of a slingshot, you know, you take these wires and typically a spring that retracts the wires themselves, yank it back to a certain point, provided the spring has proper tension. Sure, you could fling something. But human cornucopia, not necessary. Oh, she's telling me that I'm done. We'll see about that. No, of course, we'll go ahead and snag this.
Doodles.
Toodles. And that should save us. We'll find out. Anyway, we'll go here. I'll send you here. We'll kill the noise. Absolutely apologize for that. That was a sneeze that snuck up out of nowhere. Anyway, we can see that things were much different before Wayne walked the land. Nevik apparently doing something, actually. Jim Peyton, generally a piece of shit. He's weaseled his co-worker out of a contract. Apparently seems to take pride and joy in taking hazardous assignments and driving other people to do the same, despite now repeated complaints from the workforce about putting their lives in danger, and our boss Braddock seems to have jumped on that, saying, well, you know, he's worried about making nice with the locals, haha. People might die out there, Braddock. You fat piece of shit. Whatever. He's a fictional man. Braddock can't hear me. Jim can't hear me. We are observers in this. Anyway, more Jim later. More of Jim's hot jams later.